So let's take a look at building a series shortcut that's actually a series of shortcuts, because sometimes you need to have one to do one action and one to do another that matches it. So for this example, what we're going to do is create kind of a clipboard manager, a way for you to save bits of text and then call them back later on. So instead of just being able to copy and paste, you can actually copy and save these different things. And we're going to actually create three shortcuts to do it. The first one is going to save a clipboard, so whatever you've selected and copied, and it's going to save it to a file. So I've called that, it's at the bottom left here, called Save Clipboard to Clips. So I'm just calling this Clips. And I'm going to look at it right now, and it's basically just three short actions. So first thing it's going to do is it's going to ask for input, and it's going to get the name. So it's asking, just give this clip a name. So you assign a name to this clip so you can get it back later. Now, it's not really going to do anything there special. It's just going to ask for input as text and no default answer. And then it's going to get the clipboard. So that's another action that we've dragged over. And it's going to pass that into save a file. Now, in save a file here, I've selected services iCloud Drive. And I've turned off ask where to save. You can see that's there. That's on by default. I've turned that off and I've set the destination path to shortcuts/clips. And I've typed in clips and then slash and then the input from ask for input. So if I click on that there, you can see there's a way to get the ask for input here, and that then could be put in there. So I don't have to save the input into a variable and then call it back or anything. I can just basically grab that. It's a magic variable. So that's all it's going to do. And when I use that, it should save whatever I have in the clipboard there. So let's go and look at that as an example. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go onto the web, and here I've got some text. I'm going to select the text. I'm going to copy it. And then I'm going to return to shortcuts. So I could add this as a icon on, you know, the main home screen or whatever I want to do, but I'm just going to access it in here for now. So I'll hit Save Clipboard to Clips, and it's going to ask for a name. So I'll call it Part 1, just as an example name, and it saves it. Now if I go to the Files app and I look in iCloud Drive under Shortcuts, I have a folder called Clips there, and there is Part 1. Can actually even look at it, and you could see. So it saved it there. Now the second part of this is another way to save clips, because sometimes you don't want to just save the clipboard. You actually want to save the selection. You don't have that available everywhere. In other words, you can't select something, say, in Pages and then say share it. You have to copy it. So that is where you would use Save Clipboard to Clips. But Save Selection to Clips is similar. It's going to ask for input just like before, but it's going to get variable, and instead of something else, it's going to get the, instead of the clipboard, it's going to get variable, and you can see shortcut input is what I've selected there. So you can see select magic variable, and I could say I want shortcut input as the magic variable. And that's basically going to take the input rather than the clipboard, and it's going to save it in the same way. So now I can return to Safari here. I will select the second paragraph here, and I will do that, but instead of saying copy, I'll hit share, then I hit shortcuts, and then I'll say save selection to clips. Give this clip a name, call it part 2. So now we look in files, and under files we can see we have one, part 1 and part 2. Great. Now back in shortcuts, note that in save clipboard to clips, under the settings here, I set it to show in widget, and I actually probably don't even really need it anywhere else, but I could add to home screen. That would be useful. But with save selection to clips, I've set it to not show in widget, because I don't need it there. What I want it, where I want it, is show in share sheet. So when I hit share, it shows up. So two different ways to access two very different types of clips. Now, GetClip, what is GetClip going to do? It's going to allow us to recall what's there. There's no easy way to do that. It would be great to be able to grab it and then automatically paste it in. But we're going to have to run that either as something on the home screen or just go into shortcuts here. So it's going to get file and it's going to give the path there. You can see the path for shortcuts clips. So I turned off show document picker and I put that there. Then it's going to just put the output of that into choose from list, and the prompt there says which clip. And then it's going to then say copy to clipboard, and it's going to just copy to the clipboard. So now what I can do here is I can run get clip, and you can see it finds the files that are in that directory. So I never have to access that directory in the files app. We are looking at it here to see those things appear. But now that I've got this running, I can just ignore that folder. It's just the little storage area. And I could say, well, yeah, let's get a part one. And now that I've got part one, I can go and paste that anywhere I want. So, for instance, I could run pages and then paste. And that's in there. And then I could go over and go to shortcuts again, get a clip. Let's get part two now. And in pages, I can now paste that. So now I have a way to quickly save these things and recall them. And I don't really have to build too much of a management tool because I can always just go into files and then go into this clips folder here. And I could just manage these as files, right? If I select these and delete them, or I could rename them or whatever I want to do. I can manage that all in the Files app, and it's probably not going to get any easier than that. So I'll just leave that there, and I've got a nice little utility there in three shortcuts.